Andy Ackers never travelled further on an airplane in his life. Earlier this week, the native of Wigan, England, took a flight from Manchester to Toronto with his teammates and after 3 months of having the unique experience of playing road games close to home, he now gets to play a home game in a faraway land. "I've never been anywhere like here," he said. "It's like a different world," such as the existence of the Toronto Wolfpack, who brought big-time English rugby league to Toronto for the first time last year and won fans with its play, a party atmosphere in its simplistic grounds, and a group of people the locals wanted to, and in many cases did, have a post-game beverage with. It will be slightly different on Saturday when the Wolfpack face the Swinton Lions. With Lamport Stadium undergoing field renovations, Fletcher's Fields in Markham will be the venue for the 4:30 p.m. kickoff, and it's expected most of the 3,000 bleacher seats will be filled. The team is scheduled to play its first game at Lamport on June 9. The grounds will see professional rugby league for the first time after hosting generations of weekend warriors and high school players over its 50-year history. Games in Canada are also a new experience for Ashton Sims, a Fijian international who has gone through the wars of both the Super League and the National Rugby League of Australia. "It's crazy," he said. "We're in North America playing rugby league, the game we love. We've had people come to us off the street. They're showing so much interest in our game and the way we play and the way we've been going this year. We're really looking forward to playing a string of home games. It's something different, something unique. Not too many people get to say that they've played for a transatlantic team, and going for a spot in the top league next year. It has been a different experience for the Wolfpack this season." The side split between returning players and new members is playing in the Betfred Championship, a significant step up in class from the part-time sides the club faced in League One. The prize at the end of this season is a spot in the Super League. It was inevitable, changes had to be made. Yes, fans at Lamport last year fell in love with the likes of Fufui Moimoi, Rhys Jacks, Craig Hall, and Quentin Laludigaga. But the side reinforced itself with players who have Super League and NRL experience. The season also started in difficult fashion, with three significant players getting released in training camp and with turnaround continuing well into the season. The team gets many requests from players who want to be part of the Wolfpack experience. But Toronto's philosophy is to find low-maintenance guys who are willing to put work into a season of second-tier rugby league to fulfill a dream of earning promotion. "My message has always been, first and foremost, it's not about the player. It's about the person," head coach Paul Rowley said. "We've lost some players along the way, but we've been strong in our decisions, and now I feel we've got a group of players who are committed to one another and we have 100% trust and faith in each of them. I feel we've got a professional group. They're used to high standards. We've got leaders in Captain Josh McCrone, Assistant Captain Sims, and others who are good leaders as well. We're more professional than any Super League club at the moment," Ackers added. "And we are only in the championship. The club is currently the 1st of January 10, including wins over its closest pursuers, the Featherstone Rovers and the Toulouse Olympique." The club received wake-up calls early in the season with a crushing defeat against the London Broncos and a tie against fellow League One graduate Sparrow Raiders, albeit under brutal weather and field conditions. Since the Broncos' loss, the team has won 10 straight, including 2 victories in the Ladbrokes Challenge Cup. "Still, the roster turnover has presented challenges. Even though we've brought good caliber players, it still takes a little bit of time to learn the little intricacies to everyone's game," returning player Richard Whiting said. "Hopefully now we're going to come up with performances we're really going to need." The games are televised on Game TV and available online at cbcsports.ca.